Welcome everyone to another nightly random Linux and such live stream here. Let's see what is the voting power PC. Anyway, we continue with some kernel work because so much stuff needs to be done. Also recurring theme here, criticizing the amazing, maybe not, Linux kernel development. I just realized, wait a second, was it not yesterday 5.8.4? And yeah, of course, our in the meantime daily, do I make this amazing quality up or bin format flat of revert, IO Uring was missing, MM on exit. Yeah, so emergency stuff. Recurring theme here now, Linux, the new Windows of weekly emergency kernel hotfixes. Can't make this stuff up. In more amazing news, I asked here what should we test next, because we with all the work yesterday also the totally dropping frame. Speaking about anyway, other live stream improving our installer and all the other SGI MIPS, Sun Ultra Spark, P3, PowerPC and so on. Tested here our newly built, so now with we had this link time optimization as usual. I was one of the first to edit this maybe 2005 or something of that sort. Didn't really work much 2005, even 15 years later, it's like, yeah, YOLO. Anyway, so this is a Blade Runner here, the Sun Blade 1000. And I rsynced here the new build over from the workstation. And yes, I might do the extra effort, not real estate shopping like other fancy YouTubers in New York there with their repair business. But maybe we shuffle the office this weekend here and maybe have a more video graphic corner than here for better views, because yeah, too much stuff. Anyway, so rsync this to the Sunblade, can also proxy BUIN for that. So that is that side, Ultra Spark 3, previous videos. And so this is the latest build here of, well, also in what kind of time frame do we build stuff. I just built this here some days ago and now we built this already. So yeah, every other release of Linux kernel every other day we build here whole ISOs every week or so. And this one here is now LTO of etcsde config of config. So LTO equals one. And when we compare some binaries, first I was like, okay, let's do that with bash. Also not diff, but let's see, also I had this here. Obviously also L. So not benchmarking this today, but also first I was unimpressed with bash the same size, but we also have like rsync, so some stuff is indeed smaller, tiny little bit, even if here amazing Lua, so that would be that of this, and that is how much? 2%, so yeah, LTO on Ultra Spark, Spark 64, I'm not sure if there are too many people doing that, but tiny little bit smaller. We have also Xorg server, so that would be that of, that wouldn't surprise me if that is also 2%. Of course, what counts, hey, this is even a freaking 8%, nearly at least, with all the fancy whatever callouts, what size is it even. So yeah, of course it doesn't mean anything in terms of at least we save fancy storage space on our fancy fiber channel disk there, but otherwise it doesn't directly necessarily translate into performance. Of course better cache utilization stuff, but if due to more compact code whatever, the generated code could also be significantly worse, so maybe we benchmark this another day. Also, so the binaries work, I rsynced this here because the other day I was wondering will it work, and yes, it works, even although you don't see this, but X11 comes up, maybe next week, better setup here. Even Xterm, previously I've run Xterm, that came up, so at least not an instantly noticeable regression. Let's shut this down, save some electrons, because they are not infinite. Let's do some kernel work stuff. After realizing how amazing the kernel is, did I even commit this? Maybe not. Probably not. Let's see. Also, yeah, we have here more stuff. Recurring theme, way too many changes in my working copy here. Oh, I committed this already. Okay, fine. Then maybe we should also build it, because now I guess I committed this without testing. That certainly is not amazing. In other microchannel news, we had this kernel patch of 6-year-old regression previous video that we also wanted to send upstream, and that wasn't instantly accepted. You probably want to watch the other video for more details. And we still need to send this in, so other people randomly put flux on their birds. So the issue was previous video, as also hilarious, final update to this fiber channel stuff. Comment here like, yeah, don't use conCPU LE16. I think I commented this already on below the previous video. And the funny thing is, it's not even so. Yeah, also, I didn't Google this particular gentleman there. You also need to be careful what people write on Linux kernel. Does not necessarily always need to be true. Also, video is lagging because whatever. Anyway, so yeah, turns out it's not because they also say new warnings. Like, yeah, you fix the code, now the code works, but now you get warnings because, yeah. But the email is also wrong. Additionally, this patch introduces following sparse messages. The compiler generates the same code, the name of CPU function, however. Also, yeah, I mean, probably not to, I don't want to like publicly shame your people or something. That's not the point of the video. The point is learning stuff and educating, because I don't want to be the only and last one who constantly fixes this stuff. And probably I should have already realized also that the selection color is not amazing, barely visible, at least on more visible on the screen capture then. Anyway, if someone tells you use it because the name is shorter, then like, yeah, YOLO, I think probably not the best guy to listen to. Anyway, shortage of variable names and function names and stuff should probably not be a reason. So, of course, we are professionals here. I tested this, and lo and behold, so this is not tested. Also, random people tell you do this random stuff, and then this random stuff doesn't even work, because I tested this. Changing constant CPU, I said this before, I thought the name is better for some constant, matching a numeric constant, whatever I was. It's CPU to LE16 is only bit shifting. There's some stuff I could theoretically fact check that here in source exact image utility endianess, our amazing C++ endianess conversion stuff. And so the code would at the end, and where is the swap stuff even? Do we not have, no, where is that even then? Oh, okay, we include for total portability sake, we include the byte swap. But that, of course, in the end, why does this not remove that user include bits byte swap? Probably here. So yeah, in the end, our code, you see byte swap constant 16s, like, yeah. Also, why is this? What is the difference between byte swap constant? Anyway, for me, neither point whether it's constant or whatsoever. It's like, yeah, it's shifting this stuff together anyway. This is how this looks. Long story short, changing this still produced the same message. So yeah, thank you very much for that hint for proposing something that doesn't fix it. So, well, the warning is not due to constant CPU to LE16 versus CPU to LE16, but that the struct member there actually is a second struct used, NV something, NV struct used, which does not yet have the LE16 type, but just uses uint16t. Is it uint? I think it's uint. Probably I should not to contribute to more random also. This is this terminal there, because vi package linux qla something. I think I updated this already to uint16t. type, but your switch does not yet have the LE16 type, but still simply uses your 16T6, so also whatever should. So although those are constant values and the const was used previously, okay, maybe I wanted. Update the patch and send it yet call DNA and send it yet again. Also 6, so although this is constant values and the constant was used previously, should not be used anymore. Well, maybe the where do we have? I should also have. Why does this not kill this? I probably should have locked out there. Did I not have Control A kill? No, whatever. What did I even wanted to check? All right, I wanted to git grep that was constant CPU to LE16. So this is only used in that as per the previous video. Apparently, how many drop frames? Not as many today. Well, also 6, so also we should remove or convert the last other remaining user. Yeah, this is not the greatest fan actually of git defaulting to less or whatever subversion is not doing that. Remove it from the kernel entirely. Best me. I actually was wondering whether. Okay, anyway, whatever. So, yeah, this probably also, yeah, this was Emacs as a new full quote stuff, actually. Don't like it the most. I probably should fine tune this another day, but nah. So much to manual email stuff. So I guess should we proofread this? Also, yeah, documenting this, not making this stuff up. If you, well, you see the previous patches I've rushed and, well, probably even if I would have spent even more time on the previous version, I probably would still have done it the same because all the surrounding random kernel stuff. But just documenting this, how much time this really takes when people always, like companies, embedded companies, like this patch took so much, cost so much money and this took so long and can you just change this? And in the end, it's still incorrect. This is one, it's not due to constant CPU versus CPU 2016, but that's actually is a second NV struct used, which doesn't use whatever have the type, still simply uses you in 16T. I will update the patch recording and send it yet again. Also, 6, also this. Also, okay, maybe. Okay, you know what? Fine tuning the. So although they are this constant, so although this R constant values and the constant was used previously, it should not be used anymore. Well, maybe we should. Well, maybe we should then convert last other remaining user. Maybe if I feel like I can send patch for that. So whatever, what was sending directly was last time I clicked Q. No need to be careful, could leak some emails. Yes, release sensor stuff. And then let's go. What was go to? Was I need to remember this. What was our go to folder? Where could this possibly have been? Ah, obviously it's G. I nearly wanted to type that, so that would be, I think, inbox slash send or some crazy stuff like this. And what was sent again? Mu sent again was something like damn, 15 years ago I knew all this by heart. Here is something. Re-edit is capital E. Ha, capital E for re-edit. So, also maybe probably theoretically we could copy this other gentleman, as he is so happy to review this stuff from ACM, no less. Where would this would be this fine stuff? Let's hope that copied this with Emacs, even copied this amazing stuff. So let's send this again. So probably this, yeah, so this should be, it's probably in the meantime, I can, I guess we can use FV3 because for this trivialities you need three versions. So the difference, so yeah, the difference will be not constant this stuff and changing this other NV stuff, because we certainly want amazing fiber channels. So for this, we insert the file here of user source t2 clean package base Linux, because obviously we handpick it from the one and only best Linux distribution. I heard allegedly, could be right, could also be wrong, QLA Big Endian. Remove this fancy copyright stuff. So this is the same text as that. And then, so the difference is changing this here for this bloody sparse checker. So to silence those warnings, and then just for the sake of it, not use this CPU to LE16. So commit, broke, blah, 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 unbreak, but partially revert. Also mark the field, you mark, it's actually the mark the second, oops, mark the second, what is it even, struct, darn, doesn't include that here, because, yeah, so, yeah, type names at the end, totally hate that also, that was NV whatever, probably we should check that, that was driver, SCSI, QLA2XX, def.h, and then this was something like, well, frame payload. So this is here, and this is one, and this is the other, because so this is NVRAM structure definition. This is somehow twice, because yeah, this is in the initial control box. This is init. This is a SCSI command block sent to the RISC firmware. So actually, there is a RISC processor in this SCSI and fiber channel controllers, similar to other Adaptic and Simbis Logic controller stuff. Obviously, even decades ago, you had there some programmable RISC cores. This is also why so many even old SCSI and Adaptic, Simbis Logic, and all the other mega RAID whatever stuff has firmware. And so, yeah, this is init. This is a initial control block thing, and this is NVRAM somewhere of this sort of. Also, yeah, look how I really wish in the C language stuff, this is in this driver, in my opinion, somehow 1,200 commits just in 6 years, and yet not only this, not enums or something, but also often the bits open coded like magic numbers, in my opinion, especially for maybe 10,000 commits since introduction over a decade ago. maybe even the very initial review. But yeah, you see code quality standards as Linux kernels, like review details of whatever, and in the end, types and if defs, and yeah, like exactly what I would in general not recommend to do with defines, but whatever. So yeah, this was nvrmt. So mark the second frame payload size in nvrmt le16 to avoid sparse warnings. So commit this in 2014, Brook ULA on Spark 64, AGS and the Sunblade 1000, unbreak by partial revert to fix endiness in NVRAM firmware default initialization. Also mark very theoretically, I know we leave it now, but yeah, you can even this text, you can fine tune it more and more and most. And yeah. Also mark the second frame. Also, yeah, we typed this just now live on YouTube. Frame payload size in NVRMT LE16 to avoid sparse, to avoid new sparse warnings. Amazing stuff. The best stuff Fiber Channel can offer in 2020. Anyway, so yeah, three lines, three patch versions, and I don't know, 20 over 20 emails, especially with the replies. It's hilarious. Anyway, hopefully that is the final version, because I'm really getting tired of this stuff. So send that. Yes, please. Also, yeah, only with Emacs, Mew, and live on this channel. If you're wondering why I use this old-fashioned stuff, of course I don't use this. As you see, I used it 20 years ago. Stopped using it probably 18 years ago or so, 16. Use it mostly for the white spacing and line wrapping stuff, because also modern, even open source Mozilla Thunderbird, you guessed it, does white space damage and stuff, line breaks and so on. So very theoretically, let's take a look. Somehow not the very biggest motivated, also what we have here. Other fun stuff we've done here. I've not even mentioned, you see so much stuff here, the Radeon Linux Driver kernel oopses with, I think it was null-pointed georeference on Spark, as in the XVR100 on the Sunblade 1000 as well, because yeah, you see the theme here, everything very few people use is broken, and someone on YouTube needs to fix it. This patch is already in T2, because it is obviously where everything is fixed. Git status, what else do we have here? Git diff, also yeah, this was this, and was it the same or the other? Maybe, I'm not really sure. One of these versus similar. We also need to do P3 stuff, so don't forget to share, like, and subscribe for more NVIDIA RSX stuff for the P3 to come. I quickly wanted to see, I'm not the very super most, also yeah, Subversion has short forms. Also, why do I still use Subversion? There are so many reasons, including, yes, why do they not have shortcuts? It's should be status always is typing here. Somehow in Git, constantly, at least I need to constantly Google this Git magic command stuff, and getting better, but somehow even if you know all the stuff, then yeah. The reason I revert all the stuff, also certainly we can Git pull. Maybe this already takes care of, maybe could also maybe Git reset hard or something of that sort, but quickly wanted to see if we just for the pure YouTube and current Linux kernel fame, because the Debian people always, or other people down there bunker, accuse me of, hey, I've never done anything, only stupid YouTube videos. So certainly for our kernel mailing list awareness, we can just send a converting this QLA 4000 something. In general, not the greatest fan of this without the hardware, because as you see, it usually breaks something. Git checkout. But maybe let's see if that is easy, because it certainly, I wonder, we sent a patch to remove this because someone said something, and then and then people jump on me like Linus Torvalds, like, ah, why do you use my favorite lovely tiny little function from a decade ago? But yeah. Anyway, so let's see. I slightly wonder. We could actually, for the fun of it, check what the difference is. So constant, so we have here, so this is force LA64, constant swap 64. I mean, what the heck would be different between swap 64? So there's swap H. What would be the difference here? Cars are necessary for constants because we never know how for sure you something, at least. What? Cars are necessary for constants because we never know how for sure. Know how for sure how? What? Cars are a recurring theme whenever we look at something in the kernel. It is typos, broken stuff. Cars are necessary for constants because we never know for sure how. I think here is now how for. We never know how for sure how. What? Now? How for sure? My English is not native enough for this gibberish. Anyway, so constant swap. In my opinion, this is pretty unnecessary. I slightly wonder. Map to. I really don't quite get why they think they need this. I wonder how often that is even used in the kernel. Git grep, this constant stuff. So this is not even that is not used too much. Anyway, that is not the point for today. I mostly. Well, but they also see, you think, hey, can't you turn a little cleanup? I wonder what shitstorm we get when we really, although it's only used in QLA mostly anyway. If we also, what was even the, what shitstorm we get when we actually really send this in. And then it's like, yeah, someone said, but that was obviously not the most correct. Let me just check what was this with make. So make C for checker 2, level 2 of module driver SCSI. Because a fun fact, QLA also XZ minus B because PCB per thing. Fun fact, this driver gets warnings, so much to that. Yeah, it wasn't about the predefined bit sizes. I wonder more why they think there is a necessity for const version. So yeah, it's not like this driver was warning free, right? And the other driver gets even more warnings, so much to sparse stuff off. Ironically, so this is similar stuff of what we've done, just done, right? It's like so much to sparse warnings in this drivers. And, okay. Yeah, fix me, do we even need this? Always for 2x16 quantities, platform endiness issues. This is, by the way, unsafe. As far as I know, there at least were once upon a time IBM. PowerPC versus bitfields. So what this is doing is this is bitfields, and this is also a little bit fishy in general. So what this is doing is so much to people commenting, I can't write C when at first glance, each time I look somewhere, my jaw drops here. So these are bit fields, and so this is 1 bit, 2 bit, 1 bit and stuff, and this is not portable. I'm pretty sure on PowerPC, not sure if GCC still does it or only the IBM compiler, but bit fields, IBM PowerPC. This is, by the way, really set that what bit fields, what is that? IBM PowerPC something bit fields, what does the C compiler? So much to fix me. It's like, you open the kernel sources and one fix me something. So it is probably, wait a second, invalid bit field specifier for the type restricted. It's like, thank you very much. You quickly want to check something and yeah. So this code might not work necessarily for Big Endian or PowerPC due to this being reversed. So the issue is so if we send a patch in, we might get the same complaint like, hey, you get the warnings like, yeah, thank you very much, they were already there. That was 265, for example, 265. And if this is a case, as I remember for at least PowerPC or all Big Endians, then this obviously doesn't work if you compile this on Big Endian, PowerPC something. And the hardware, certainly this hardware is external hardware config registers, as the comment. So yeah, comments like, right, so the comments says exactly what it says here. So it's like, yeah, thank you very much. Somehow, in my opinion, a little bit how comments probably should not be done. But certainly this might be as broken as the Spark 64 byte swapping stuff we just fixed in the other driver. But yeah, if you want to test that, then if you want me to test that, you certainly can send such a hardware over, because I don't have it. So I think there was git sed, right, is here, no? What was it? Was there not some git sed thing? I thought there was, is there a git sed commander equivalent for git grep full name? I thought there is a... Not? How boring. Because what I was thinking to do is, so like, yeah, we could either copy that, or we could either copy this, or I usually do this quickly, like cut d field 1 unique, because multiple occasions, and then sed. Really wonder how much shitstorm we will get for that. But people ask for it and now they get it or so. So sed that too, according to amazing comments, that would be something of that sort. Also, somehow I have the feeling this is not my time best spent, but that is theoretically what they were asking for. Also g for multiple, like globally multiple occurrences in one file, one line. Also apparently I did something stupid of, obviously we need here back tick, and maybe we revert stuff. So this is how this would look like. Very theoretically, if they really mean it, and obviously not this here. To me, yeah, it's a little bit funny. That they have their macros that are preprocessor macros that are not used and maybe should not be used. But yeah, make, let's see, let's make here driver fs. Do we not have, oh, do we have here fs? Oh, obviously that's not in driver. Driver j ffs2. Does it do what it's simple version? Maybe, maybe not. What do we even have here? No, we have this as module, so. Oh, wait a second, this was 2. We also have JFF. It's 2. What did it complain about? Or maybe this worked and just didn't. No, maybe not. What is wrong with this stuff now? License super. We could obviously just build this. FS JFFS2 JFFS2 KO. Probably should maybe do that or whatever. Do you think? New kernel options because. Or did I never configure this? No, I think I configured this. I think I built this previously. Ah, come on. Maybe I should have node to mod config, whatever. Okay, that was somehow not the most efficient way to do that. Let's see if it's doing this. So let's see what else do we have there. Custom necessary, so that's the type of predefined bit size. Yeah, I'm not talking about about the sizes. I'm talking about, what was it even? Was it, oh, this was swap, right? I'm talking about this constant, not certainly this cast here, because this is anyway not a function, but yeah, also in the question is also, by the way, coding style, leave in the comments below. In my opinion, I would avoid preprocessor macros at all costs wherever possible. Error prone also, yeah, also this is why you often see do while stuff or other safeguarding stuff. In my opinion, this probably would be best to have a regular function and mark it as always inline. Probably generates much better diagnostics and produces the same code anyway. And yeah, this cast is obviously necessary to make sure that the types here are the same type, but I only wondered about the constant, and I wondered about, certainly this is a little bit, yeah. Not one was not wondering, why is here this mod post of, what is even, so this build we have now, okay, mod post is, yeah, we didn't build all the modules because Linux kernel module system. I only wonder, does this checker stuff now works with this configured or still not? Ah, no, it works, whatever, maybe the config wasn't fully okay. So we get, what do we get here? The question is, of course, so I think this probably has not to do with our changes. This is just a random C code quality you get from the Linux kernel. The checker always finds something because something, random stuff, and as shown here, random fixes, hot fixes each and every other day in the meantime. So yeah, live here on this channel, warning, incorrect type in argument one of different address space of struct bin log apparently on, where is it even apparently in slightly wonder. Also note how somehow it is here in like schedule signal age, so it doesn't even apparently necessarily tell you where in JFFS2 this is coming from, but yeah, monolithic one address space stuff, certainly super good recurring theme here of super good idea to run everything in one address space and let each other clobber and stuff. So yes, very theoretically, this is how you mass substitute here some stuff, very theoretically. I slightly wonder if we trigger someone sending this in. This is funny, why is here, this is CPU, here's another constant CPU to, this is used more often, git grep of CPU32. Certainly it doesn't make the most sense to just substitute. Yeah, this is as often used in the QLA. It's like, can't mix this stuff up. So SED, can never SED too much. But in, as I said already, this is somehow beating a bit. Long day and stuff. Somehow beating a dead horse, I wanted to say. Git diff. So, did we substitute this correctly? Of course, little and so check out of those two. Git diff. So, very theoretically, slightly wonder. They said it's longer and shouldn't be used in drivers. So, I don't know. Should we send it in? Leave me the comments below. I'm also wondering slightly, do we get a warning? Probably we get here some warning of that is not identified as most amazing as they probably want it anymore. Huh? But yeah, not, I mean, yeah, amazing macros that are barely used and apparently shouldn't be used because now they are long and whatever, constant YOLO. I didn't make this up. Mails I got from fixing Fiber Channel on Spark 64. You know what, we have done it, we can theoretically also just send it in. So yeah, the code will be the same anyway, the warnings as well. LE16, slightly wonder. The problem is if I throw this file through some indent, then probably everything changes. Not the greatest fan of indenting for not the very most reason. But yeah, anyway, leave me as usual, leave me in the comments below. This will also be one, of course, I will continue here, not only for the YouTube live stream, but in general, because I certainly need my Octane and UltraSpark stuff to work. Like the only one who plugs in an XVR100 or wants to run X on this in a UltraSpark in 2020. So we will probably continue to fix some stuff, but I'm more like with this kind of stuff and yeah, emergency patches can't make stuff up. Also microkernel, as much as I've run and still run Linux in 2020 and for 20 years, but this is really not cool. Also this new high performance IO ring missing MM on exit. It's like, yeah. In warning PID add. Also netlink, reallocate, policy export. Yeah, also 2020. S-tool omit netlink reply feature were changed. It's like, yeah, legacy S-tool user space tool shows an error when no features could be changed. So still have netlink reply to be able to show this error when update features wasn't called. And it's like, yeah, can't mix this up. You would really think this trivialities are long fixed. But yeah, probably share, like, and subscribe for some modern kernel work. Probably also review some other stuff. But yeah, as always, leave in the comments below what you think to all of this. Probably we can send this in. I slightly wonder, does there exist some so 16 we have that probably shouldn't be in 8, but you never know. No, there isn't. Should there be in 64? Hey, there is, but only, yeah, so somehow they probably got this from somewhere, so much to copying other people's stuff. From glibc or I don't know what, GCC, I have no idea. So git blame, where would that be? CPU to 2012, four, so this was only changing the stuff, but yeah, whenever that was introduced. So we had here LE64, so this is only in zip file. We also have Big Endian. This is not even used on 32. This is a little bit used in, yeah, let's maybe better not touch that, not to make the... Anyway, this is what I thought if you have constants and use it, but nah, whatever. I mean, this is totally silly, even with constant stuff, so it's just some constant versus not constant. It's hilarious. It's anyway, not YOLO, not our construction site. Let's send this in. Maybe they applied. What if I don't know? Ah, oh, right, they don't have short forms because it's good. So, yeah. Let's dump this in. Let's just dump that in there. Let's fire up our precious Emacs with mu and then call it a day. And yeah, no mu wants to operate. So let's go here to this email to, and yes, I'm aware that I'm not showing this, can't leak all our too many private emails. Where is it even? So that was Mr. Bart von Asch, and that would be that one, I think. And then we could make him maybe happy. Also, yeah, I really hate this. I need to check how to remove this again. So let's delete here all this stuff and let's see. Additionally, what do we even? Ah, here. Okay, maybe we leave that in just for always nice to say hi. And then working on, just wanted to, questions only what we're working on. I mostly wanted to finally get this freaking, also, yeah, it's theoretically fiber channel stuff, stable kernel versi, right? Because it doesn't freaking init your fiber channel stuff. And doing some surrounding stuff because, yeah. So whether constant is used, yada yada, the compiler genetically the same code, yeah, no shit Sherlock. The name is however short, sir. So following your recommendation, here is a request for comment, removing all few other constant CPU to LE. What did we had? We had 16, 32, and did we had 64? Not really. Oh, we can grab that theoretically in. Did even had a 64? Did we, what did git grep say for LE? Okay, didn't even had that, but 32, right? 32 in x4 constant. So, so following your recommendation, here's an RFC removing all the few other remaining. Can also just patch SCD. SCDR use CPU LE 16 patch use stuff. I mostly do this for the fun of it because I find it so hilarious. I will probably, so usually also, yeah, in general, this is really silly, right? Moving some, this is exactly what I see. It's so ironic. It's exactly what I hate the most, just changing code to change it. And we will certainly also do some programming 101 stuff also, 2.5% drop frames, 2200. In my opinion, exactly the unneeded codes change stuff that rather breaks stuff than not, but I have to admit this constant stuff is vastly superfluous, looks ugly and long and stuff, and they mentioned it, and it is mostly in the QLA 4000 driver when we just touched the 2000, and so yeah, let's see what they do. Did I, by the way, test build this? Probably not. Let's test build. Nah. Driver QLA 4XX. Also SCSI. Time to sleep. QLA 4XXX. Let's see if that hopefully. Probably. No. Stop. What? No build target. Fine. QLA 204. No, QLA 4. Do not have SCSI here. What? QLA 2. We have here QLA 2, but not QLA 4. Nah, whatever. Not my problem. We only substitute. Probably it's fine. It's maybe in the same header and was done with SED, so don't tell them we didn't fully test it. But yeah, long story short, this is how kernel developers spend. Also, here, looks, this is funny. Kernel quality, in case I make, you were wondering, do I make this stuff up? Am I overly critical of stuff? It's like, yeah, just code review and another different, you know, usually you only hear the kernel developer like Linus Torvalds and all the other David S. Miller and all the other 1,000 famous people. And they only pray C, C, and more C, and the most C. And look, this is hilarious, right? Unsuccessful woman YouTuber here. This other stuff was already so constant my S, right? Underscore, underscore, constant my S. This freaking code here in SIF's SMB2 stuff was already not using this constant. So why the freaking heck do they have this constant stuff when they barely used it? And here they have in the same file, CPU2LE32, like who the freaking heck ever reviewed this code waiting for the unsuccessful woman distribution guy here live on YouTube to come along in 2020. But yeah, also here JFFS2 CPU here to also, yeah, CPU2JE32 is like seriously, but whatever. Here CPU2LE, and anyway, you get the idea. Also, here's more of this fun stuff because, yeah. Anyway, it's like, yeah, whatever. I wonder how much they will jump on it if they complain, but constant our constants, which is, of course, theoretically constant, but there's also plenty of other places like the SMB stuff. Anyway, so following your recommendation, here's a RFC removing all the other few remaining. So following your recommendation, here is a RFC removing all the all the other few remaining instances theoretically. Ah, there. What is this, my typing today? Would also be a couple of, probably should not even tell them, you know what? Theoretically, I could see how good their code review is. You know what? I don't even tell them, but don't tell them. I know that there are some big onion things, not to rub it under the nose, that theoretically they could. The big onion stuff I didn't really feel like touching today because, yeah, that was. Anyway, let's see how good their code review is if they find this themselves. It's of course a little bit evil from us. Let's would be TCP of constant stuff here. I could troll them in terms of if they accept this. I have no idea what will happen with this. But if they theoretically maybe, actually this is, maybe we should make this, what was the Linux kernel mailing list? Because that is, of course, not for SGASI. Also, yeah, I didn't get a single reply for set standard. Let's go to, also I didn't open this, this was G4 inbox send for set standard. Set standard we send to the Linux kernel mailing list, that would be this. There we have it. And yeah, whatever, should we? Ah, we can figure this out themselves. Anyway, I'm curious whether they will either accept this or not, and if they accept this, if they will notice that there are a couple of big engineers left. If they accept this, then we can make another live stream together and get SED substitute the big engineers. That's it for today. Let's click on send and on, yes, really send this message. And yeah, this is how active processes quit anyway. No, maybe no, we sent it. Let's double check whether send inbox sends much to quitting this, and then probably it's sent, looks like it was sent, quit mu, yes please. So yeah, coming up soon, more testing, there's this questionnaire, but so much to how you can spend open source, not earning much, certainly not enough for real estate in New York City. Hey people, 1PS3, obviously, surprised so few people did I overload you with. Also yeah, people comment below and then don't comment below, that is not how this works. But yeah, UltraSpark we just tested, theoretically burning the whole ISO. Yeah, obviously P3. So P3 we next need to fix our acceleration to be more usable, coming up sometime soon. Then also some this testing, probably not hour-long videos, just putting it in there. And yeah, we also have some new SGI stuff coming. And microkernel, because I'm really tired of this kind of stuff. With this kind of stuff, I mean, this kind of changes, hot fixes the day after, because the previous day hot fixes were not enough. Oh, certainly, this was much bigger. So yeah, they release stuff and it's too broken. Let's next day. You know, a decade ago we would have made jokes and fun out of Apple and Microsoft, but no. Anyway, so more microkernel discussions sometime soon. Sean voted for SGI. That is cool. So we have some new SGI surprises here, and you heard it here first. Tiny little, I didn't even announce it. Imagine you have the nearly only bootable SGI Octane ISO and nobody knows about this because you didn't even freaking announce it. I wanted to make make a properly edited video celebrating this. So T2, you heard it here in the night between all the stuff. First T2 revision 50,000 here, summer celebration in July without yet big news announcements, because we are not shameless self-promoting people here. First, well, it's the second ever bootable, as far as I know, the second ever bootable Linux ISO on an SGI Octane. But the other one was a proof of concept and is not as amazing. This here is fully, this is a fully T2 installable stuff and latest and greatest from a month ago. And yeah. All the fine details, we're working on new stuff coming, and certainly yeah, more SGI stuff, because you can never have enough, and PS3. And again, this kernel stuff just for the fun here, education, how to do kernel patches, and also a little bit of how after 30 years of Linux kernels, you would think each code line is reviewed 1,000 times and is perfect, but then like, yeah, don't use this constant because, yeah. Anyway, that's it for today. I hope you learned something. And I hope to see you soon for the next fun stuff and videos to come. And 2,200 drop frames are not as bad as yesterday.